Hey everybody, what's going on? Welcome back to my channel. We are back for another episode review of Pose. This is season 2, episode 5, What Would Candy Do? Let me let y'all know, I already know that the review is late. I apologize. Okay, look, a bitch just had a lot going on throughout the week, but you still got some other banging reviews. It's just this Pose, it took a little bit of time, you know what I'm saying? But either way, we are here. Before we get into the review, if you have not done so just yet, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel. Let me know what you think about this video with a thumbs up or a thumbs down, and then hit the notification button so that way you will know whenever I upload new content. All right, y'all. This episode review, I'm not gonna make it too long because the episode was good. It was better. It was lighthearted from the dramatics that we had to deal with losing Miss Candy from last week. I'm still not over that shit right there. And then next week it looked like, pray tell, Lord have mercy. Don't do this, y'all. Don't do this, okay? But the episode review ain't gonna be that long. Y'all, I apologize. These lights are hot. But let's go ahead and get into the review, shall we? Okay, so Damon is working over at the YMCA, and he got a line wrapped all the way around the corner of these rich white ladies trying to learn how to Vogue. Now, everybody and their mama and their sister, uncle, brother, Tracy, cousin is trying to learn how to Vogue. Now, mind you, Vogue been popping in the ballroom scene, right? Everybody who knows about the ballroom scene knows about Voguing. But it took for Madonna to learn about it from the ballroom scene, for her to take it to mainstream, for her to make it popular, for her to make it a big thing. Like, it's a news lady out there. She doing her own little YouTube report and shit out there on it. Like, it's popping now. Mind you, again, the shit been popping, but now it's popping. It's okay to be popping, you know what I'm saying? And so, Damon's, one of the girls at the YMCA, chick at the front desk, I don't know who she is. Anyways, she tells him that she wants to add on another class because, you know, he's been highly, you know, suggested. This Vogue class is like the number one class that they got there. And so they want to add on another class. She's like, women are willing to take their draws off just to see you in the class and see you dance. He was like, girl, I will teach any class you want. Just don't let them bitches pull their goddamn pants down. Let them hoes keep their shit on. And that's what we want. We don't want none of that. But Damon is in there. He's teaching the class. And he's just making all the ladies feel good about themselves. He's pulling Big Mama up to the front. Big Mama getting her little shine and shit like that on or whatever. And so afterwards, after class, it's a recruiter that comes up to him. She tells him that she is looking for some audition. She's looking for people to audition for this new upcoming tour that's coming up. It is the Madonna Blonde Ambition Tour. And of course, Damon is super excited about it, and we are excited for him. So when Damon gets home, it's dinner time at the house of Evangelista. And so it's Angel, Poppy, and Blanca. And so they're excited for him. They're the only ones left that's in the house right now. Wow. So they tell him that, you know, they're excited for him. Blanca's telling him how proud she is of him. And he's telling her about, you know, how the recruiter said that she was going to push him to the front of the line. And how, you know, she thinks that he's amazing, yada, 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 right? At the same time, Ricky is over at the house of Wintour with Miss Electra Abundance, and he's giving her the same information, basically the same spew that the instructor or the recruiter gave Damon, that she wants to put him to the front of the line, that she sees the, you know, the talent in him, that she wants him to audition for the Madonna's Blonde Ambition Tour, right? Now, Blanca, again, you can see the two parallels of the house. Blanca's house is built on love. It's built on, I'm proud of you, you can do this, I'm rooting for you. Yes, you know, she's like, you doing good, Angel doing good, like, I'm so proud of my children. Meanwhile, over at the house of Wintour, Electra Abundance is proud of herself. She is thankful to herself for all of the dedication that she has put and the sacrifices that she has made for her kids. And so she is just, she's making it all about her. She's turning Ricky's dope ass opportunity and his dope ass moment into her moment so she can shine, and how basically how she's so proud of herself. So it was just, it was crazy. I was like, what? But you know, That's electro bonus for your ass, child. So later that night, Blanca and Damon, they're washing dishes or whatever, right? And again, Blanca is telling Damon how proud she is of him and this opportunity that he got, but he still needs to go and he needs to get permission from Miss Helena. Miss Helena is his instructor that got his ass a scholarship to the dance class that he's at in the first place. Excuse me. So she was like, look, I don't mind you going for this audition for, you know, this tour or whatever, but you need to go get your permission from Miss Helena. If she says no, then the answer is no, because you only got one semester of school left, just one. So you can't fuck this up, basically. So he ends up, you know, you see back, he's back over there at school or whatever, and he's like the star pupil of the class. He's the one that the teacher calls out when everybody else is doing it, everybody else fucking up. So they call this the one star pupil out and they doing this shit. And this is how you're supposed to do it. This is how it's supposed to look. Yeah, I done been in situations like that before. I don't give a fuck how they do it. This is how I do it, goddammit. But you know what I'm saying? Ooh. Suppressed memories. Take it back. Anyways, he ends up taking his instructor out to coffee, and he tells her, you know, he has this opportunity to go out and audition for the Blonde Ambition Tour, right? And she totally understands, because she says she had the same opportunity where she's working at now. When she was in school, her instructor thought it would be a bad idea for her to go and pursue her dreams of dancing for the man that she's working for now, and look and see where she is right now. So she totally understands that. And plus, she says that she wants him to be seen. Back then, it wasn't a lot of us afforded opportunities like that. And so she wants his face to be seen in a room full of faces that don't look like him. And so she's totally down with it. He's finna go on audition, y'all. Oh, but her one stipulation was, you do have to come back and you have to get your degree. I don't give a damn if you go and you go on tour and you go on 5,100 tours. You still need to bring your black ass back to school and you need to get your goddamn degree. And that's what it is. So they're back over at the house, starting off at the house of Evangelista. Everybody's helping Damon get ready for this audition that's coming up, right? Poppy's helping him buff up. They out there doing push-ups and all this sweaty ass shit. Blanca's waxing his unibrow and, you know, getting his brows and shit like that up. And over at the house of Wintour, Electra lets him know straight up, look, I'm not going to coddle you, I'm not going to hug you, I'm not going to praise you, give you a good job, this, that, and the other, but I am a provider. So she gives him a stack or whatever, right, and tells him, here, go take this pretty woman and make their ass up. And then that's what they do from there. And I thought that was, you know, at least that was good of her to, you know, give him money, but at the same time, it was all about her. It really didn't have nothing to do with him anyway. It was all about her. But on a side note, Electra, she tells him, oh yeah, Electra does tell Damon that, she tells Ricky, when you get out there on the dance floor, I want you to leave him like bloodied and scarred and running back to a brick of a mother of his. And Damon, Ricky kind of looking like, okay. It was just weird when she said it. Anyways, side note, Electra and these goddamn kitten heels, they kill me, y'all. They kill me. She too damn tall and her feet are too damn long for her to have them little ass heels on. But then again, I understand that's how some people say about big girls or short girls being in heels. Yeah, I know I'm 5'4", but I like me some big ass goddamn heels. And yeah, I might look like I'm probably gonna tip over a couple times, but that's my motherfucking business. But then when I stand there and I strike a pose on your ass, bitch, I'm cute, but don't let me run, because yes, I will fall over in them big ass heels. But you know what I'm saying? That's neither here nor there, but it's just some kitten heels. They catch me every goddamn time. I just be like, ooh, Electra, you look like the back of your heel is scrubbing the ground. Like, I can't. So, it's time for the first audition, right? Now, it turns out that Damon and Ricky are actually in the same group. Now, when it comes time for them to audition, now, mind you, I love me some Damon, but I gotta give it to Ricky. Ricky got out there and, baby, he showed out. His lines, his moves, his arms, his precision, he was bomb as hell. He did good, in my opinion. They were right to have him right up front. He should have got it out of all them damn dances, because quite honestly, Ricky was the best out of all of them. So later on that night, you see both Damon and Ricky both, you know, they're nervous or whatever, because, you know, they're waiting on the callback. So finally, they both get the callback that they both got called back for the second audition, right? So they're excited. Damon gets the call. Blanca hugs him. They hug each other. They so excited, right? Goddamn Ricky get the call. He got the call back. He go back to hug Electra. Let's look at him like, nigga, unhand me, nigga. What the fuck? I did not tell you I'm not a fuzzy bitch. Don't hug me. He was kind of like, I was, baby, that took me to goddamn out. She looked at him like, nigga, do I fucking know you? Y'all, so Ricky really was fucking around with that dude, Chris. The dude that came up to Damon in the bar a couple episodes ago and told him that he was just mad because he was fucking his man. This nigga Ricky is over at Chris's house, right? Ricky getting ready to go out to the ball. Chris is like, you know what I'm saying? Let's get in there real quick, you know, before you go. Ricky like, no, I need to save my energy because this is the last time I get to practice before the second audition. He like, man, a little bit of humping ain't gonna take away your energy. Like, no, like, come on, let's do this. He's like, no, man, I'm telling you, I gotta go. I gotta go to the ball. Chris gets pissed and it's like, oh, you gotta run behind. You're a slave. You gotta run behind your master. And basically tries to call him out, basically saying that he's a little bitch to Electra and that he wishes that Chris has everything that Ricky wishes he had, like his own place and his own independence, and he's his own man. Lord, these two motherfuckers start getting into it. Excuse me. Ricky tells him, I hate that I blew up my life for you, and I never should have left Damon for you, and yada, yada, yada. And then he tells him, because you a spoiled, narcissistic, stuck-up bitch. This motherfucker Chris gonna say, boy, bye. I'm blessed and highly favored. I'll never be alone. I was like, I'm done. Take it. I'm done. You know how mad you got to be to bring Jesus up in a goddamn conversation when you say, boy, I'm blessed and highly favored. You mad. That being you so mad, you ain't even got no words to say, so you just gonna try to throw God on him. I'm blessed and highly favored. Boy, bye. Then Electra goddamn crazy ass. Lord, this heifer say she had a plan. She was thinking to herself, what would Candy do? She backstage or back wherever, back over there at the ball, talking to her kids. This bitch done brought Candy Hammer to the ball, wants one of them to accidentally drop the hammer on Damon's foot to get him out of the running to be in a goddamn video. If this bitch Electra ain't crazy, this bitch had a whole hammer. A hammer. So Angel and Poppy go and find Blanca, and they, I don't know if it was Cubby or it was Lamar, one of them, I get both of their ass, they both some house hopping hoes, I get them both confused anyway. One of them was the one that told Blanca that Electra got this goddamn idea, and Blanca was like, man, she always talking shit, doing shit, did she actually bring the hammer? He was like, yeah, she got the hammer, bitch. Blanca was like, oh, hell no, not my baby. So she went over there and confronted Electra about it. Electra basically, she eventually gave up the hammer, but this bitch was really gonna do this. Like she said, she was like, you always ruin my fun. Bitch, fun? You was really finna smash a nigga foot just to try to meet my goddamn Donna. Really? So, y'all, they back at the ball, right? And the category is Butch Femme Queen. Butch Queen Femme Vogue. I fucked that up. I don't know how many times. Y'all know how many times it took me to do this part right here. Anyways, that is the category. And so Damon's out there. He out there ripping it up. He death dropping and doing all this fabulous shit, right? Then Ricky come out there. I don't care what nobody say. Ricky is a better dancer to Damon than me. I'm sorry he did. Even this time. Ricky got out there and he showed up. He showed out. He was ripping the goddamn runway or whatever, right? So when it came down to the scores, Damon ended up getting all 10s. Ricky got, I think it was 4 10s and 1 9. So, of course, Damon ended up winning the trophy, right? Electra gets pissed off. Pray tell on the mic being shady as he do. Oh, bitch, you mad? Bow, bitch, get the fuck on up out of here, bitch. That's what he tells on the mic, girl. Pray tell, petty, but I love him, right? So, later on that night, Ricky is... I don't know if they were at the bar at the same, you know, place. So they were, I think they were there. Yeah, they were at the same place, whatever. Because it's cleared the fuck out. It's only the scragglers that's left up in there. They in the club when all the lights come on and, like, they sweeping up. And it's only, like, a few people here and there. These people that's, this nigga that's trying to get this bitch number in the corner. You know, shit like that, right? And then that one nigga that's at the bar that just can't let shit go. That was Ricky's ass, right? And so Damon comes out to him and he was gonna give him the trophy. He was like, nah, you know, you earned it, you deserved it, yada yada yada. So he apologizes to Ricky. He tells him that, you know, he was better with him and that he broke up with Chris and that, you know, he was wishing that he was with him, yada yada yada. Damon was like, look, you know, I love you, but we just gonna be friends, period. So later on, y'all, we see that neither one of them end up getting the call back for the Blonde Ambition tour. It was this other guy that was in the group with them that actually got the spot, right? But that same recruiter got them a spot on the reboot of Solid Gold. Now let me tell y'all, Solid Gold was one of my favorite shows as a little girl. I love Solid Gold. That and Soul Train, I loved it. I used to want to be a goddamn Solid Gold dancer. So when they were doing like the redo of Solid Gold, because they used to play like the top 10 songs, and like it would be these people, like exactly how it was in the show. They dancing, you know, to the song or whatever. It took me back. They were playing Sinead O'Connor, Nothing Perfect Gentleman. I wrote some of them down. Poison, BBD, you already know. Janet Jackson, Wilson Phillips, and of course Madonna's Vogue. And then afterwards, again, Ricky apologizes to Damon, and he's basically trying to get him back. And Damon is like, look, you know, let's leave this what we got on the dance floor, because I don't want to mess up nothing that we got. And you never know, we could be big stars, you know what I'm saying? And plus, he ain't trying to fuck none of that up. Y'all, that was pretty much the end of the episode. This episode was okay. Like I said, it was lighthearted. It was definitely better from, I wouldn't say better. It was more lighthearted than last week when we had to deal with the death of Candy. But like I said, next week, it looks like now Pray Tell is finna start getting sick, and my heart can't take that, y'all. I'm not built for this shit. I'm a Cancer. I'm sensitive. I can't be crying and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? It's not good for my skin. You already see how I sweat. But anyways, y'all let me know what y'all thought of this video. Hopefully I made it entertaining enough for you. Let me know what y'all think. Please like, comment, subscribe, and share. And I will see y'all in the next video. Peace out. What's up, y'all? Do me a favor and share the video. Please make sure to subscribe to my channel. Let me know what you think, and hit that notification button so you will be up to date when I upload my latest videos. I holla.